All right, guys, how's it going? Barely a week ago when I launched my epic update video, I noted right at the beginning how I was about to discuss leaks, which can generally be taken as almost 100% guaranteed fact. However, sometimes either the leaker or myself misunderstand something. I'll get to that in a minute. However, first of all, let's go back a little bit further when I first introduced Intel's Cooper Lake back in my Intel's epic battle AMD heads to the moon video. It's safe to say that AMD's stock price has come back down to earth with a bump since then. Nvidia's too, actually. But concentrating on Intel for now, in that video, I noted that I was leaked information about an Intel dual chip design some 3 months previously. And here is what I said. Around 3 months ago, I was leaked some information by a new source of an upcoming Intel 14-nanometer dual chip design. Intel appeared to be trying to catch up with AMD's core count by sticking two huge near 700 square millimeter Skylake SP dies together. Cooper Lake will generate and deliver a significantly better generation-on-generation performance improvement. So perhaps it's not all that surprising that TDP is also an eye-watering 350 watts. At least according to Charlie over at SemiAccurate, who first broke the Cooper Lake name, I believe, and he likely has far more details than I do at this stage. Note also my policy of giving credit where credit is due. When I cited Charlie at SemiAccurate as having far more information, I also did this in my latest epic video where I gave credit to Canard PC for being well ahead of the rest of us on Rome's 64 cores and 256 megabytes of cache. This is something which I always try to do, even though I don't always get the same back from the tech press at large. I also speculated that Intel may go with a lower core count than 56. 56 cores would be the maximum their two glued together chips could provide. However, the combination of yield and power was almost certainly prohibitive, and in the end, late last night, and over at Anantech we see, ahead of the annual Supercomputing 2018 conference next week, Intel is today announcing part of its upcoming Cascade Lake strategy. Now, many of you are likely aware of AMD's Next Horizons event tomorrow, the 6th of November, where they'll presumably be discussing a slew of 7-nanometer products, including Rome, their upcoming 64-core server chip. Those of you with good memory, especially for humour, will no doubt recall the last time Intel upstaged AMD, back at Computex in June when they first demoed a 5GHz 28-core monster chip, which was apparently coming on the desktop towards the end of this year. They just forgot to mention that they overclocked the chip using industrial level cooling. Still, that was a small PR victory over AMD's planned 32-core Threadripper reveal the next day. So Intel is again back at it, upstaging AMD's planned event with a new chip. Instead of having the maximum 56 cores, it has 48. And unlike with their 5GHz 28-core desktop part, this one doesn't actually require industrial level cooling. There's only so far you can lie to people buying servers. However, as mentioned in my Intel's Epic Battle video, powering this 48-core chip will surely require a lot more power than is desirable. So now onto the slides, and just for the purpose of clarifying why I'm late with my video compared to some articles, Intel obviously doesn't give me slide presentations or any information on their upcoming releases. The first I knew about this launch was 30 minutes before they went live with it late last night. The rest of the tech press get this information maybe a week in advance and are given time to prepare. So that's why I'm slow with some of this stuff. I'm sure most of you have figured that one out by now, but every so often I get a question asking where my video is a few hours after this information hits the public domain. Well, that's why. But as we see, it starts with the business update before Intel quickly starts getting down to details, including the new Cascade Lake advanced processor, the new Xeon E processor for entry one socket servers, and the new Optane DC persistent memory. Don't think that one's actually new, they talked about this back in May. We've got a data defines the future slide, and a slide going back over how Intel used to be great, with 20 years of Xeon platform leadership. This next one was interesting. 8 million server CPUs shipped in the third quarter. Staggering numbers, which goes a long way towards explaining why they're currently undergoing a 14-nanometer shortage, which has led to some pretty ludicrous pricing on their desktop parts, as well as record revenue in the third quarter. Finally, we get to what we care about though, and Cascade Lake again, promising leadership performance, security mitigations, optimized cache hierarchy, Intel deep learning boost, higher frequencies. Now that was an interesting one, given what I just said about power. And lastly, optimized frameworks and libraries. The most interesting slide, this one, is next. Announcing Cascade Lake Advanced Performance, a new class of Intel Xeon Scalable processors. And as we can see, it's 48 cores with 12 channels of DDR4 per socket. The current Xeon Platinums are of course 28 cores with 6 channel DDR4. Cascade Lake AP, however, is only scalable to 2 sockets for a maximum of 96 cores. Going quickly over to Anantech's article again, and something I hadn't considered but was picked up by the author, Ian Cutress, who said, Intel is still keeping a lot of details for Cascade AP under wraps for now, but what we do know is some high-level specifications. Cascade AP processors will be up to 48 cores, possibly with hyperthreading. They wouldn't disable hyperthreading on these parts, would they? I hadn't even considered it, but it would surely help a huge deal with power consumption, and as we just learned, clock speeds will be higher. Now if you're going to be struggling on power, why would you also increase the clock speeds? It doesn't really make any sense. But surely a 48 core, 48 thread part will get destroyed by the current EPYC 7601, AMD's 32 core, 64 thread Naples chip. Well, not according to this slide though, where we can see an incredible up to 3.4x performance in Linpack and up to 1.3x in Stream Triad. That's against the EPYC 7601. And here we see another incredible deep learning inference up to 17 times the images per second, and that one is against their own Intel Xeon Platinum. I used the word incredible there because that's what I meant. Impossible to believe. But as anyone following my channel knows, the thing about presentations is they usually end with footnotes giving further details on how the systems were set up. And given this is Intel, let's just skip right to the end of this and configuration details. Okay, so Linpack AMD EPYC 7601, it's on a Supermicro motherboard using two AMD EPYC 7601 processors with SMT off. Now to be fair though, Linpack should be benchmarked without hyperthreading, and that's what they've done. It's just a little bit curious that they decided to show the Linpack result in this particular case. Now what about this DL inference? And once again we see a 2-socket Intel Xeon Platinum 8180 CPU with hyperthreading disabled. And it's all coming together in a lovely conspiracy that only Intel can provide us. Too much power in 48 higher clocked 14 nanometer cores? Just chop out the hyperthreading, disable on your competitors' chips and your own, and still claim a victory. Going back to the beginning of this video where I talked about sometimes a leaker or myself misunderstanding something. In my last video on this server topic, I misunderstood a comment where my leaker told me about Intel being stuck with Cascade Lake until 2021. We were all of course expecting Cooper Lake to be their glued together MCM, but my source told me it would be Cascade Lake all the way until 2021. Obviously, I interpreted that as meaning that the OEMs were going to be sticking with the current 28 core Xeon lineup, that they wouldn't go with this 56, which we now know to be 48 core Cooper Lake parts, due to power restrictions. What it appears we may be getting instead, however, and this is just purely my speculation, is 48 non-hyperthreaded cores with slightly higher clock speeds. Power consumption will be down a lot on 48 cores, 96 thread parts, and so will be performance. Looking at my leak today, and it's clear it's even more legitimate, as the OEMs will indeed be sticking with Cascade Lake, because Intel have just changed the name from Cooper Lake to Cascade Lake. Looking back at my first leak as well, and we can see that some OEMs were worried about Intel's ability to deliver Ice Lake, that's their 10 nanometer server parts. Also note the last sentence which talks about something interesting. I now analyse that as likely being Intel's FEPU, their future enterprise processing unit, which I first leaked in this last video. It is really, really interesting and exciting to see how all of this comes together and the validity of my sources increases with each new piece of information. So I'm done with this one. It's much shorter than usual for a couple of reasons. First of all, I talked about some of it in my last channel update video. We know Next Horizons is tomorrow. And when I woke up today, I intended to cover both this Cascade Lake and Next Horizons in a video towards the end of this week. But why do that when it is simply costing me and making videos longer than they have to be? So now you'll get two videos with the same information and I can refer to this one in my next. On top of that, this waiting is just costing me. I had information on Cooper Lake 14 nanometers before many did, but I didn't release it instantly, instead preferring to wait for the right time when I could give the whole story. This happened recently too with the last epic update, and I was beaten to the punch, you could say, by Charlie over at SemiAccurate, who released his article a day before my video launched. I believe we both have different information. However, looking through some of the tech press, I noted that Charlie was being cited while I wasn't. My delays in this are simply costing me. Obviously, getting the information out more quickly doesn't mean I'll be the one cited in future. However, it does mean that they will lose their excuses for not citing me as the original source. If any of you wonder why I point out my firsts, stuff like this should hopefully go some way towards explaining it. But there are no more miracles to be engineered on 14 nanometers for Intel. Their bolt is well and truly shot. But be sure to check out the Anitech article on this topic for even more details. As ever, it's a great read, and the link is in the video description below. I'll catch you later, guys.